In today's video, we're going to discuss some of the reasons why a Shih Tzu might not be the best breed for you. We're going to look into their exercise needs, any medical issues linked to this breed, and plenty of other things that you should seriously consider before potentially adding this breed to your family. Welcome back to the Fenrir Shih Tzu channel. If this is your first time here, my name's Charlie and I'm a certified canine leader here at FenrirCanineLeaders.com. Everything we do here is dedicated to helping you find the perfect breed for you and then helping you become a high-level canine leader who can raise the perfect canine companion. If that sounds like you, then make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell to make sure you never miss another upload of the Fenrir Shih Tzu show. So let's dive into some of the reasons why you possibly shouldn't get a Shih Tzu. Let's start by looking at the exercise needs of the Shih Tzu. They're a lively and friendly dog who loves a good run around the house or in the backyard, but that is about as much exercise as they need. If you're looking for a dog that fits into an active lifestyle and to take on long walks, hikes, or go for a run alongside you, then a Shih Tzu might not be for you. Next, let's talk about the grooming requirements. Shih Tzus have absolutely stunning coats and they look adorable with both long and short-haired coats, but they can take a lot of work and time to maintain and keep them looking at their absolute best. If you choose a Shih Tzu and keep a long coat, then you have to commit to a regular daily grooming routine. If not, the coat will become incredibly matted and tangled. For some dogs, they absolutely adore the extra fuss and attention of being groomed, but others would rather do anything else than sit around and be brushed. You can avoid the need for daily grooming routines by deciding to clip off the long coat and opting for a short-haired version. However, this still poses a challenge. Despite what some breeders might try and suggest, they are not hypoallergenic at all. Shih Tzus actually have a double coat and they shed a lot. The short undercoat is what causes the long coat to become tangled and matted. Removing the long coat makes looking after the short coat a lot easier, but the trade-off is the short coat sheds a lot more, leaving plenty of short hair sliding around your hardwood floors or caught up in your carpets.
Hey guys, very quickly, I just wanted to ask, are you following us over on Instagram? If you're not, there's two accounts I would love for you to check out. The first one is our brand account, at Fenrir Canine Leaders, where you can see more about our industry-leading products that we create. If you're interested in following me personally, that's at I Am Will Atherton, where you can see behind the scenes of me working with some of the most extreme behaviour cases in the world and what it takes to run these kind of YouTube channels. And maybe if you just want to be able to come over and chat with me, that's the place for you. So there'll be links down in the description box for both of our Instagram pages. I'd love for you to come and check them out and hopefully we'll chat over there.
Let's touch upon the training and temperament. Shih Tzus can be extremely stubborn dogs. Although they're sweet natured, their stubbornness can cause them to become manipulative over time. They're highly motivated by food, and if you use this as a primary way to train them, food then becomes the only way they respond to commands in the future. They're also known for being difficult to house train. Because of their small size and small bladders, it takes time for them to develop to a point where they can hold it. You have to be persistent and patient with them, and even experienced dog owners find that they take a long time to house train properly. Finally, for this video, let's talk about some of the health concerns associated with the breed. There are several health concerns to consider. They can suffer from different eye problems, including dry eye, where one or both eyes don't produce a normal level of moisture, which can lead to infections or ulcers. Cataracts, where the eye lens becomes cloudy, affecting their vision. And progressive retinal atrophy, which can cause a loss of sight over a long period of time. Their short faces cause them to suffer from breathing difficulties, and their respiratory system is compromised, and they can really suffer around things like freshly cut grass and other forms of pollen, as well as suffering from the effects of cigarette smoke. So if you're a smoker and not willing to quit that habit, you might want to reconsider if the Shih Tzu is a breed for you. There are plenty of pros and cons to adding a Shih Tzu to your family. It's so important to make sure you do your research before purchasing or rehoming any breed. There are so many dogs out there like the Shih Tzu being purchased without this knowledge. Their owners soon realise that they don't have the time to exercise or train them, or they realise they require a lot more grooming and care than they originally thought. There are too many dogs in shelters, so please only commit to this beautiful breed if you're certain you have what it takes to look after them for the rest of their lives. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and you found it useful. If you did, make sure you hit that like button. And if you're new here, make sure you subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell so you never miss any future updates. We have two regular Shih Tzu videos dropping every week. So I can't wait to see you again on the next episode of the Fenrir Shih-Tzu. Apparently I can't say that. So I can't wait to see you again on the next episode of the Fenrir Shih Tzu show.